All right. Hi, guys. Welcome to Powerline. This is another deck profile. I was walking around Clarkson's, our local, as always, looking for new and upcoming talent, and I met Minnie here, who was playing against our buddy Clark, Salty Clark, as you know him. That's my boy, dude. I could call him that. And I caught her with a Age of Feather deck, and so she's going to profile it for you guys today. Go.
Okay. So my starter is Black Candle. Basic starter, 4 mana. And she mainly plays the damage. Of course, it's Generation Break 1. I'm not able to do that, but yeah, simple starter.
I think I'm bleeding.
Next is Nocia. I only run two of these. They're great for when early or late game. Especially when you need that little extra boost to defend your Vanguard. I only run two. I don't need any more than that. Must have in the deck. It helps actually maintain the deck pretty well. It's a great booster, especially behind the Vanguard. But I like to keep them on separate occasions. I run three. Honestly, I'm always odds and ends with the numbers, but three has been working out really well for me.
Best card ever.
Back on the air. I run four of her. She's a stride. Discard her. She's right through three. Simple. I run four because I usually tend to run out of her. Perfect guard. Four. Must have.
Now you run the new ones as opposed to the old ones. Why?
I was preferring the old ones over the. I was debating. I like the old ones a lot, but the new ones actually help out a little bit more.
Okay.
Especially when I get into those little tricky situations where I can't unfold. So I need that little. It's really rare, but it does come in handy, and I ran into that situation once. Nurse of Broken Heart, I run four of her. She not only works with the Vanguard, but she also affects herself. So, and it also works during the opponent's turn, so that's also great. That's a good defense boost right there. And then Texas. Again. I only run three. I don't see that why I need to run anymore. But yeah, no. Another great attacker, another great. Especially with the strike card coming out. It helps out, and it also helps in your ending game when you have 5 damage. Black Slice Harm. I don't really use her that much, because I don't usually have any open chance to do it. Because when I do it, it usually backfires on me. But other than that, she has a really great effect to mitigate damage, but only when she's boosted. So, other than that, I just use her as an attacker. Nothing else. Running three. Again, what I love about this Nocielle is that the damage doesn't need to be flipped down or up. You can just take it. So it's a great way to unflip damage. I run Nocielle because, as you saw, I have plenty of Nocielles in the deck to be able to have her play go off. And I do love using her just her effect in general, because when I don't ride into my main grade 3, I can run into her and be semi-safe. My main grade 3 helps manipulate the minute you stride. Helps manipulate the damage the minute you stride, so that's actually really well. Especially when you have Pegasus on the shield. Or Broken Heart. My triggers are the heal, obviously, recycles itself, so actually really well. I run 4. People tend to run 3. 3 really doesn't work with me, so I just run 4. I do run the stand trigger because it's actually really important. When doing damage, especially for what I love about it is that you take 2 cards, whether face up or face down, put them back into the deck, and then top 2 again. And then you draw a card. I've seen people pull this off with Pegasus over 10 times. Because they were able to draw into that much.
So that's why you don't play the no CL stand.
Right.
Okay, I see you. I can pick up what you're putting down.
Yeah, I've seen someone actually run out of dice trying to calculate. So that's but that was extremely lucky. I don't know how they pulled it off, but they did. I run 4 of them. And then the rest I run is crits. All different crits. I love her because she gets that little extra boost if needed. Other than that, that's what I run.
So what's your strides look like?
Okay, my strides are different because I do run no CL. I do run one of her. What she does is, again, she bleeds damage. 2 cards onto the field, 2 cards into the soul. But the thing about her is she also helps out no CL. So if I were to have a no CL and damage the grade 2, I would bring it out. Usually that usually won't hit anything, but if it is a no CL vehicle, it gets a plus 5 boost. So that also. Especially when I have the no CL in the heart. Great on hit, great pressure for early game, so they won't let you leave the soul on the limited damage so early. Razor, great for late game, especially when you have ponies on the field. 5 damage, 5 put back, 5 come out. So that's a really nice boost right there for everything. And then my main grade 4 that every angel player should be running, Raphael. Just heal. Simple heal. No matter the damage, no matter if you're even at 1, heal.
Well, thank you for doing this deck profile mini. I really appreciate you doing it. I know I caught you off guard by asking you to do this. But, guys, if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below.